Dogs all around the world have provoked emotional responses in people who never thought they would feel again. Therapy dogs are there to provide comfort to people in any circumstances. There are around 4,500 therapy dogs in the UK, which all poke a smile on someone's face. One of which is Bonnie, who we met today whilst visiting Pensmeadow School, a school for those with severe learning difficulties.
It's fabulous. I mean, Matthew, for example, didn't want to go anywhere near Bonnie when he first met her. And now when we turn up, he recognises who Bonnie is and does a little dance of joy. And then he'll get the lead because he knows that that's his responsibility. And that's hard work. That's, mm-hmm. That's what we've progressed over the 3 years that we've been visiting school. And it's really nice to see the change in the children that perhaps might have been afraid of dogs and now aren't. And in post 16 as well, one of the classes they had, we went and helped with how to interact with people and animals in the park. So some of the children can talk, they do go to the park, but their social skills in relation to how to deal with meeting a dog in the park and to make sure that you ask the owner if it's all right to stroke the dog, to always do that before they actually touch a dog, and the reasons why. So just to be a little prop in all of that was quite handy and quite nice.
How has the therapy dog helped the pupils?
It's a sensory experience when Bonnie comes into the class. Our children in class have got complex needs, but they're aware she's in the room. They get to stroke Bonnie and interact with her. It's really nice to see. So Bonnie comes to them instead of they going out to Bonnie.
Well, all the pupils love any time that Bonnie comes into school. Everybody gets really excited. It helps them with the communication. So you can offer the children choices for when they're working with Bonnie, encourages them to use their voice or choose another method of communication. And it's very relaxing for the children, so you can stroke Bonnie and pet Bonnie, and it's a really nice atmosphere.
When the dog comes into class, all the pupils notice her, and some of them do get really excited. Some of them are scared, obviously, they're a bit wary, but it's helped their confidence with dogs. And when we're out and about in the community, it definitely helps them out there. They're not as afraid of dogs. And I remember a few years ago, we had a boy, and Bonnie really helped him. He was petrified of dogs, and he actually touches them now, and he will touch an animal. So dogs, any animals, but no, Bonnie's really helped.
So would you recommend any other schools look into a therapy dog?
Oh, most definitely, yeah. You can see the difference with the children. The smiles on the face, and they actually reach out for Bonnie. They'll hold a lead, take her for a walk around the school. It's amazing.
Based on our experience, definitely. It works at our school, and Bonnie's got her own timetable, so she goes into all the different classes. Some children are quite nervous at first, but then the more they get to know Bonnie, the better. I think it would be beneficial to all schools.
Definitely, I think it's just a lovely thing to have. Like, just, they won't have an experience of a pet at home, so bringing the pet into the school, letting them just have that, being able to walk the dog around school, giving them a treat, it's just a completely different experience for them.
I spent my time watching. As you saw there, the effect Bonnie has on the children is remarkable. It's wonderful to see the joy one dog brought to the children. Any breed of dog can become a therapy dog, they just have to have the right temperament. We met with a dog trainer to tell us exactly what it takes to train a dog. My best to embrace the darkness in which I swim.
Now walking back.
How long have you been a dog trainer?
About 12 years. Yeah.
And what made you want to become a dog trainer?
I've always loved working with dogs, and I volunteered at the RSPCA when I was younger and kind of saw that side of rehabilitation. So that got me interested in the training side of things. So yeah, just my love of dogs really.
What makes your job so rewarding?
I think it's the end product. You know, we're training dogs to help people with blind and vision impairment, so knowing that you're contributing to giving someone their independence back is really rewarding.
What does the usual training process entail?
A lot of hard work and a lot of time and patience. It's usually a 2-year process. By the time the dog's about 2, they're qualified and working, hopefully. So the initial stage is puppy walking stage, which is a volunteer stage. They do a lot of the socialisation and the basic obedience. The dogs come into training here at about 1 year old. And then we teach them the basics of the guiding work, so harness work, task work, curb work, avoiding obstacles, that kind of thing. And then they move on to advanced training for another 3 or 4 months, and they start to consolidate everything and then think about the matching and the partnership, and then that process takes another month or so, and then hopefully they're qualified by the end of it.
What are the challenges of being a dog trainer?
Yeah, there are definitely challenges, because I think, keeping in mind we're dealing with dogs and they're also individual and they're not robots and they've all got their own personalities, so just the same as dealing with people really, you've kind of got to set your skill set depending on the personality of each dog, so that can be tricky sometimes depending on the dog.
Are any dogs untrainable?
I wouldn't say untrainable. There are some that aren't easy to train for this specific task, so for guiding work. We'd like to identify those dogs as early as possible, but yeah, there are some that just wouldn't be suitable, and we can't force the dogs to do anything, so if we don't feel they're suitable, then we remove them from the programme.
The increased success of therapy dogs is continuously being recognised by the medical profession. They have been asked to help with the rehabilitation of stroke patients, mental health and phobias.
When he met Bonnie, he made such a fuss of her.
It's meant that I've got that continuity of a dog that's helping me recuperate, keep going in my life.
An animal that I've trained and is part of my family can make a difference to the lives of other people that aren't as fortunate as we are.
Is she a happy dog or a sad dog?
Happy.
The number of places they are visiting is also increasing. Schools, universities, nursing homes, the list is becoming longer.
We haven't seen Bonnie regularly, but we have seen another pet dog called Jack, who's a Labrador. And every time Jack's here, Humph wants to take him for a walk out and about and around the area. And he really seems to gain from it because he comes back really happy.
When we went to Scouts, we went to Beavers, my nephew, and had a conversation. I was talking to the children there about what therapy dogs can do and where they go and where they visit and what they do. And then I went round and asked each of the children what they had learnt from their 20 minutes. And one little boy said, Bonnie has a very special job.
You must have just sold me something, haven't you? Or was that just me?
As I said before, any breed can become a therapy dog. If you or someone you know has a dog that you think would fit the role, don't hesitate. They can make someone's day in ways others can't. And you know I'll go your way.
Obviously meant to be. Bonnie is meant to be a therapy dog.
Absolutely.
That's it's her calling.
Yeah.